Hey guys, welcome back to another video. As you might know from my previous two videos, I am a PhD candidate in experimental physics and I do quantum computing research. In the comments, you've asked me to make more videos about physics and about physics Olympiad and about my research journey. And I thought today I would just sit down with a cup of chai and talk to you about how I got to doing quantum computing research from starting all the way from my physics Olympiad journey, because I am willing to bet that many of you have similar research goals and dreams. So my goal isn't to try to inspire anyone, although if you are inspired, then that's amazing. My goal is to simply share my story. That way we can connect meaningfully, and it'll also help me guide the videos that I make. So if you're new to the channel, I'm Debo again. I'm a PhD candidate at Duke University. Let's dive right into it. I think my physics journey began back in 2011 when I was in ninth grade and Bangladesh Physics Olympiad took place for the first time. I was encouraged to participate by my school physics teacher, and I studied for a week and I ended up getting fourth place in the exam. I got a shiny gold medal and I was very inspired and very encouraged. I was hooked to do physics problem solving, but my parents were a little hesitant about doing physics research as a career choice. So I began arguing and trying to prove to my parents that I could do this. I stayed connected with the Physics Olympiad community and I participated every year. I finally got to go to the International Physics Olympiad and represent Bangladesh. The Olympiad took place in Kazakhstan in 2014 when I had just finished 12th grade, and I ended up getting an honorable mention along with my teammate Fahim, and it was a moment of pride and joy and celebration for my family, our coaches, and the whole team. Now, if you think that you need to be great in physics and math to be a physicist, I'm here to tell you that it's not as important as you think. Yes, I was good in math and physics and I enjoyed them in high school, but I have still struggled with physics and math as long as I've been a physicist. What matters a lot more is passion and persistence. And I think that's one thing that I did right as I was starting out in physics Olympiad. I have had many failures, including in 2013 when I was finishing 11th grade. I had a chance to represent Bangladesh at the International Physics Olympiad, and in the final team selection exam, I came sixth. The team is only five people. It really broke my heart, but it was also a good learning lesson to improve on my calculus and other problem-solving skills. And so I practiced a lot more and came back prepared for the next year. In 2015, I started my undergraduate journey at Princeton University. It was a new country, new place, new friends. The physics classes were a lot harder and more fast-paced than I was prepared for. And I quickly realized that I had neither the passion nor the skills for doing theoretical physics. But I also enjoyed experiments a lot. My first summer, I worked on a computational biophysics project in a fruit fly lab. And my second summer, I actually worked in a silicon quantum devices group with a professor whose research I had been looking into even when I was a high school student, all the way back in 2010, 2012. And I dreamt of working on quantum computing in his lab. So that was a full circle moment for me. My last summer in Princeton, and also for my senior thesis project, I worked in a superconducting circuits group where I was fabricating 3D cavities and connecting them to make interesting geometric lattices and using them as a test bed for quantum simulation problems. I graduated in 2019 with a bachelor's in physics, and I was ready to move on to grad school. Quick break. Are you liking the video so far? If you are, I would really appreciate if you leave a like and subscribe. Also, do you like cha? I love cha, and I often on weekends have them early in the morning. And my mom would say, nah, you shouldn't have dutcha this early in the morning. It's gonna hurt your stomach. But the hole in my heart that it fills is much bigger than a hole in my stomach that cha can make. If you love cha, we can make this a series where I just get cha and talk to you guys and tell stories about research, about conference travel, about all these other things. yeah, let me know. Okay, on to the next part of the story. In 2019, I started graduate school at the University of Maryland. I joined this cutting-edge lab that was working on trapped ion quantum computing, which was basically making one of the most advanced quantum computers in any university with atomic qubits, and then applying them to answer physics questions. This was an amazing time too, as I was surrounded by gurus of atomic physics and quantum information. Until we had to move in 2021. My advisor had taken a position at Duke, and this meant that we had to move our labs, including our quantum computing devices, all the way from Maryland to North Carolina, where I am now in my current lab. Might make a video on this in the future, because not many grad students get to say that they've moved a quantum computer across states, and I moved too. So if you want to see that video, let me know. Here at Duke, I continue to work on a second generation quantum computing system from the first generation system that I started experiments on as a grad student. It's nerve-wracking, but exciting, and I'm looking forward to studying really new interesting physics with our systems. And that's a recap of my physics journey, kind of 10 years in the making. If I could go back and ask my 16-year-old self what he thinks of what I'm doing now, I think he'd be really excited and amazed, but probably not surprised, because my 16-year-old version was laser focused on a career in physics. So in many ways, I am living the dream, and I'm grateful for it. Not everyone gets the same opportunities that I received during my physics journey. So I want to pay it forward, and one way that I want to do that is with these videos for you guys. If you're watching this video, odds are that you're interested in a STEM career. Maybe you want to do a bachelor's or a master's or PhD in STEM, but you don't know where to start. Maybe you're already an undergraduate, but want to secure summer research positions, or you want to apply to US universities and start a career in STEM. If you have any questions about any of these things, let me know in the comments. I read all of the comments and I do consider them for future video topics. Anyways, I'll see you in the next one and have a good day.